I will have a drink of water. Do we have a microphone? We do have a microphone there. So, do we have Minister in the House as well? You are there. Right, I just needed to check that, otherwise it's not going to go very well. I very, very cleverly left my next script here because we're going to segue directly into the close. Okay, so I will just let everybody take their seats. Settle, please. I'm delighted that the room is filling up again at the end. We are on the home stretch. I've got to do that. It's the English pantomime spirit, and it is Christmas. So, hands up and a big cheer if you're feeling good at the end of this event, that it's been worth your while to be here for whatever reason that you came. Hands up. That's a very, very, very good result. So I'm very pleased about that. So may I welcome again EU Commissioner Mariya Gabriel. We also have with us the Austrian Minister for Transport, Innovation and Technology, Norbert Hofer. Esteemed winners who are about to come up and get all emotional, ladies and gentlemen. In this last session, we really are going to celebrate our socks off. I know it's a pain in the bum I keep asking you to clap, but I can tell you it feels less echoey up here when you do us that honor. So just, you know, you've been sitting on your bums all the time. You can exercise the top half of your body and clap, because we've got more awards. We've got more prizes to give out. So we are now going to start, we've got a lovely bumper for that, I think, with the Innovation Radar Prize. Thank you. Okay, fabulous. You see, this is how, up to the moment, how super cool we are. This is a digital conference, and here are the winners on this piece of paper that's just been slipped to me. We love it. I am a bit of a Luddite, as I say, but we also heard from Alessandro earlier the importance of writing, which is in itself a digital technology. So there we go. It's all coming full circle. So the Innovation Radar Prize. This is an initiative which is supported by the European Commission that focuses on the identification, well, actually, the identification, supporting and championing. This is very, very key words. Very, very high potential innovations and the key innovators behind them in Horizon 2020 projects. Okay, so it's an initiative that involves assessing the maturity of innovations developed within the FP7 and H2020 projects and identifying the real potential innovators and innovation. So it's all about, really, I would say in a nutshell, breaking out of the lab. It's really those products and services that break out of the lab and get close to the market, and the key word here is excellence, okay? But before we find out who the winners are, I think more eloquently than I, this video should explain a little bit more. Can we have the video, please?
The EU's Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Programme has been investing billions in Europe's future. Thanks to this support, Europe's finest researchers and innovators have delivered major advances in technology and science. Their breakthroughs are to be found in every corner of Europe, from Lisbon to Tallinn, from Dublin to Nicosia. At the heart of this success has been Horizon 2020's role in sharing excellence between member states. The result is that today Europe stands as a leader in areas such as health, digitalization of industry and deep tech. Horizon 2020 funding is smart money. Many Horizon 2020 supported innovations have potential to follow in the footsteps of Skype, Arm Technologies or TomTom, all of whom received EU funding in their early days. In the last 3 years, some patented solutions with such potential were awarded the European Commission's Innovation Radar Prize. In 2015, the Slovak SME Broadbit won this prize for their sodium-based battery technology, which has huge disruptive potential. In 2016, the winner was Dutch spin-off Intrinsic ID for their unique cybersecurity solution, which they are now selling to clients around the world. The 2017 award went to CATEC, a Spanish aviation research center, for their industrial drone that integrates a robotic arm, sensors, and advanced software. But there are thousands of other market-ready innovations emerging from Horizon 2020 and deserving of wider attention. And now the European Commission's new Innovation Radar platform makes it easier to detect and champion such innovations. With a few clicks, you can explore these innovations, searching by topic or by their market readiness. You can also navigate on a map to reveal breakthrough innovations from your region. The Innovation Radar tool provides you with the means to discover exactly where and how Horizon 2020 is delivering.
Fabulous. Okay. EU Commissioner, can I invite you, Mariya, Gabriel, can I invite you to come forward, and the Austrian Minister for Transport, Norbert Hofer. I will henceforth just call you by your names, if that's okay, and not the preamble of your titles. There's a little bit of standing around and looking very happy and giving out prizes. I trust that is okay for both of you. I love this. They're coming from both sides. We need to go here, because we're going to use the lovely hashtag. So let me get my envelopes. That's very, very critical. Okay, stand wherever you like, in front of the I, in front of the C, in front of the T, I don't mind. And let me just make sure, I don't want to give anything wrong. There we go. Right, so first of all, the Industrial and Enabling Tech Prize category, okay. Now, this prize category aims to recognize new technologies and components developed with EU funding that have industrial relevance or potential to enable the emergence of new applications. Okay, is the winner? Well, I'm going... No, what am I doing? It's you. Look, you can see my brain is fried, can't you? I'm like this. Where am I going? Oh, the envelope. This is for you. It is not for me. So I would like to ask you to please announce the winner of the Industrial and Enabling Tech Prize category. Thank you very much. Have we got the same one there? We do. We're good. We're good to go. So the winner is, please. No. Oh, thank you. Sorry. Oh my God, my brain really is. I'm sorry, you need to move out the way. I need to get, no, you're going the wrong way. Here we go. Oh my God, you are absolutely right. I'm so sorry. There we go.
And the winner is?
Thank you.
New infrared technologies.
New infrared technologies for their innovative use. Well, come forward first. Where are you? Ah. For you, my lovely. Yes. Come forward, come forward. Walk the blue carpet. It's not red, I'm very sorry. Semi decided on blue, but you know, it is the EU. Okay, so here we go. A nice round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. Photographs, please. The lady in the trainers. You need to look at the lady in the trainers. She is the most important one. Anyone with a smartphone, just ignore. Okay. We're there. Oh, oh, very good. Very good. God, it's the only person who's been organized on stage thus far of people coming up. Thank you so very much. We're going to whip. Do you want to say, well, if you want, but I mean, a couple of words?
Well, thank you very much.
A couple of words.
It's a pleasure for our company, and we hope in the future to be here again. Thank you very much.
That was pretty good. That was 20 words, but pretty good. Thank you. So, in fact, you can stay on stage with us. Do stay on stage with us. Okay, so I'm going to put that there. I don't want it to roll off. Okay, so we are now at the excellent science category. Okay, I just don't want to do one of those awful, bad Oscar rewarding reading out the wrong person. We don't want to do that. So, excellent science category. This prize category aims to recognize excellent scientific work supported with EU funding that is emerging from labs around Europe and critically shows market promise. Okay, so that is for you, and I will give you a microphone. Voila.
And the winner is Technical University of Denmark.
Well done. Come forward. Thank you. Thank you. Come, keep clapping. Come on. Come on. Well done. Look, go in the middle. He set the... Absolutely, you should be going in the middle there. So, you won for a technology that can keep... Don't listen to me. Just smile at her. I'm using the time well. So, the Technical University of Denmark won for a technology that can laser print ultra-thin optical lenses for the mass market. Is that correct? Very, very good. Do you want to say just literally no more than 20 words like the fellow before you?
Just a thank you.
Oh, okay. All right. Don't disappear. Don't disappear. Stay there in the living. You may sit, sir, if you like. Sit wherever you like. Oh, he stood up to give you a round of applause. Right. Where are we next? This one. So the next one is, I will give it to you already, the Tech for Society Prize category. And this prize category aims to recognize new technologies impacting society, obviously, Tech for Society, and citizens, developed in EU-funded research and innovation projects. So, you may indeed announce the winner.
And the winner is University of Iceland.
University of Iceland, the sound of vision. Thank you. There you go. Where are you? Where is the University of Iceland? Hello, University of Iceland. You're taking a very casual stroll. Such a casual stroll, you actually put your hand in your pocket there. Nice, nice touch. You can keep on clapping, please, because he's come a long way across the floor. Voila. Please do go. Now, you smile while I say what it's for, because that's important. If you can all come together and please smile. So this is for University of Iceland for Sound of Vision. It's a wearable assistive system that helps visually impaired people to better navigate the world around them. Is that a correct summary of what you do? Have you got your photo, the official photographer? Okay. You, one or two words, do you think?
Yeah, a few of them. But I really hope that we can bring this to the end users. I mean, that's the next step.
Okay, okay. And what's going to enable you to do that?
Money.
I knew that was it. Thank you very much. Okay, a warm round of applause for this gentleman who can go there. Okay, so the focus while you were out of the room was also very much SMEs when we were talking about the HPC. So now we are coming to the best young SME prize category. So it's really aiming to recognize dynamic SMEs that were established in 2012 or later, so young ones, and who have been developing great innovations with EU support. Fabulous. That's the right one, that's what I heard. Okay.
And the winner is MultiWave Technologies.
MultiWave Technologies, please come forward. Thank you. There's the trophy. Come forward. Oh, good. Two of you. Very good. Very good. Keep clapping. Don't even think you can't stop clapping. Thank you. Okay, gentlemen, come between or go wherever you would like. You need to. So, just look there and this, the win. MultiWave Technologies. I'll just wait for the music to drop a little. Okay, I'll shout over the music. MultiWave Technologies won for their metamaterial technology that improves the signals captured by state-of-the-art MRI systems. Is that correct? Okay, see how good my writing is? Go on, say a few words.
Thank you so much for the prize. We're very honored. We'd like to thank also our partners from Institut Fresnel and Aix-Marseille University, in which project we're participating, in Project M-Cube that was funded by the European Union. And we look forward to bringing this innovation to market. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Voila, you may go into the lovely room there. Okay, I think we're nearly there. What have we got? We've got, well indeed, overall winners. So we've got 5 and 6. So now we have, you're all terribly correct and proper there, standing to attention. Look at them, they don't even sit. Very, very impressive. Very casual. I'm liking it. Okay, so Best Early Stage Innovation Prize category. And this category aims to recognize innovations that show promise, hey-ho, in the early stages in EU-funded R&I. Oh, you're there. EU-funded R&I. Thank you very much.
And the winner is BioInitia.
Welcome. Come forward, please. Perfect. Thank you. Welcome, sir. There you go. Yes. Thank you. Keep clapping. Come on, please. It really helps. In the middle of them, please. Yes, absolutely. So, just to say that BioInitia has won for their surface adhesion breakthrough that can revolutionize the efficiency of solar panels and food packaging. So fabulous, is that correct? Thank you, I love that. You're smiling but also answering me. Very, very good multitasking. Would you like to say a few words?
Yes, I am really amazed to see, you know, the level of entrepreneurship that I've seen yesterday. So I would like to really offer this to all participants and finalists, and also to the team of Bionisia, who's really great. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Go and join these good people in their living room. Okay, so now we are coming to the Grand Prix, the overall prize winner. So that is for you. And exactly, that is the correct pronunciation, indeed.
And the winner is GRTN, Green.
Green, indeed. No, you are correct, isn't that? Green. Can Green please come forward, please? Woo! Thank you. Welcome, sir. Thank you. You can keep clapping. Thank you. That is one happy face. So, let me just say in a nutshell, because it's nice to know what you've won for. You've won for your breakthrough technology for upcycling PET and polyester. And you have developed, this I have on the highest authority, an industrial-grade prototype that uses microwave radiation to increase the proportion of plastics that can be recycled while also increasing the quality of recycled plastics.
Perfect.
Is it fabulous? Did I do that well? Okay, thank you. Say a few words.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for this prize. It was hard to get it and was hard to develop. And I hope we're gonna spread around Europe to solve this problem of packaging. Thank you.
Yeah, oh yes, very good. Thank you very much, sir. Stay where you are, stay where you are. You might have to shift along a little bit because what we're going to do, because then it's done and I don't have to invite everybody at the end, can you all come in for that? I love that expression, the family photo. So you may wish to come forward, gents. Do come forward. Let's just orchestrate that so it's done. Make sure you have your trophies. Try not to have finger marks on them, but it's too late. I love the way you looked at it lovingly there. You looked at it lovingly. So come. Here is perfect. We're going to do thank you. So is that, are they too wide or you're good? You're right. Yeah, perfect. Okay, if you feel like clapping, even if it's just one or two, or whooping or anything, thank you. Thank you, sir, in the fourth row. They all look terribly smart, don't they? Yeah, lots of happiness for the sneaky smartphone girl. Voila! Yay! Big eyes. Fabulous. Am I good to release them? Okay, so, no, apparently you stay with us. Yes, we did agree you'd stay with us. Do you mind going into the living room? Not you, Minister, not you, please, Commissioner, but can everybody else go in the living room? Take a seat, relax, drink some water. Take a microphone, sing. I don't mind what you do. Just chill out. So, fabulous. Thank you. Are we good? Do you feel like those are sort of my assistants on a TV show? Okay, thank you very much. I tell you, I'm going to have a quadruple gin and tonic the second I walk off this stage when we're done. But thank you very, very much. Intravenously applied. So, we're now coming to our next awards. And the next awards are FIWARE, FIWARE. So I think we have a lovely bumper, do we not? Perfect. So let me just give you just a heads up. I don't know how familiar you are with this. Well, it's obviously something with the city of Vienna, so it may well be. But the FIWARE, it's an ICT challenge. It was launched by the FIWARE Foundation with the city of Vienna, the Linz Center of Mechatronics, the Vienna Business Agency, the Wien Energie. And it's taken place here at the event, and I love that because it's truly, truly immediate. This is what it's all about. And participants have been busy creating apps that make cities better places to live in. We talked a lot about that the digital citizen yesterday and how cities are at the heart of that. And these apps are using real-time data from the cities and other data sources together with the FIWARE open source components, okay? So I think the teams pitched on the 4th of December at 5 o'clock and they presented their apps to the jury literally today. I love the immediacy. So it's literally the results are hot off the press. And the best ones are going to be used in by one of the challenge partners and also win prize money to the tune of 10,000 euros. So this time you are going to be the envelope opener, if you're all right with that. Do you wish to be? Do you wish to? Okay, it is you. So let us look at this. I love this. I've just got ceremony and then nothing else. And then I go here with this bit of paper. Okay, so ceremony because it's so hot off the press. So first of all, let's look at this one. Challenge one. Smarter together. So, and the commissioner will announce, oh, there's quite a lot of people there. Okay.
The winners are... Winners. The winner team is Maria Tsiakovri, Marilena Crisanto, Philokipros Lulianu, and Pekka Nikander, Errol Galit Serget.
Wow, I don't think a BBC News presenter could have done that. Okay, nice for you. Can you come forward, please? Thank you, come. Ah, lovely, okay. Fabulous, so come. Congratulations. I actually have some incredibly young people on the stage for the first time. This is brilliant. So, are they okay where they are? Are they all right where they are? Official photographer? Yep, you're with her. I'm with her. Okay, so, go on, come on. Just for the fact that they're under 20 should make you applaud. Come on, a big round of applause, please. Big smiles. Okay, hold that thought for 1 second. I simply cannot talk to all of you. Who just wants to say a word about whether this has been fabulous or really hard or... You? Go on then, you say something.
First of all, thank you very much for this prize. It's an honor for us. And we would like to thank the Kios Research Center that sent us this event. It was hard work for the first 48 hours to develop an app. I hope this will help people to get out of their houses and learn their city and get rewarded with our application.
Okay, okay. And you said the first 48 hours, did you sleep? It's okay, see, it doesn't show. And of course I should ask, forgive me, my bad, as we say. So you talked about just a little bit about what the app is. I should also ask you, for you guys, to of course just say a couple of words.
I want to ask
thank you.
One, I'm not sleeping from 48 hours and oh God.
48 hours and what did you say?
I'm not asleep.
You're not asleep for 48 hours?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
And just explain digital city in a sentence.
So a digital city is an idea for gamifying citizenship, allowing you to gain points and reputation in the digital world by helping the city with various tasks. And then based on the reputation, you can consider reductions on public services, and you can use the points as like community currency for buying local services from the SMEs.
Okay, oh nice, and I should, because it's not fair. Did you want to just say a couple of sentences about, because I didn't actually give you a chance to just explain.
We just wanted to make people go to their, to learn their city. For example, here in Vienna, we get the data from different data sets. And so, play like a game. You can go learn your museums, any tourist sites, and that sort of these things. And you can get rewards at the answering some questions based on some information. You can get points, get rewarded.
So you're incentivizing people to make the most of their city environment.
Yeah.
You're spoon-feeding them getting out and about. Thank you so very much. A warm round of applause to these good people. And you may sit in the living room with these people in their suits. Go for it. Go for it, go for it. Go and sit with the suited and booted. Now you've got the T-shirt people coming. Okay, so we've got challenge two now. Challenge two is all about... informing, engaging, and participating. So let's see who the winners of that are. Voila, that's for you. Thank you.
And the winner is the team of Antonio, Zara, and Iris Cuevas.
Antonio and Iris, can you come forward, please? Where are you both? There you go. Thank you. Where are you? Thank you. Thank you very much for your coordinated entrance. Don't stop clapping. Simply don't. Just don't. Thank you. Thank you. So you know where you need to look. There's a bank of photographers there. Look straight ahead, please, to the lady in the trainers. Look as happy can be. Oh, don't look at me. Yes, be happy. You won. Thank you. You are very spirited. Okay, so would you like to just say a couple of sentences about this?
So thank you so much first to the FIWARE Foundation for this idea and the event for organizing, mainly to the Linz Center of Mechatronic for being able to dedicate their time to explain to young entrepreneurs and people how their daily problems and try to solve it with generic platforms like FIWARE. And thank you to the European Commission for supporting FIWARE and making this digitalization feasible for everybody and all European citizens. Thank you so much.
Did you want to say something about what the... No? Oh, I love it. That's a rare thing for somebody to say no. Thank you very much. Have you been sleeping?
Not so much.
No, because when you're your age, we don't see it. We don't notice it. A very warm round of applause, please. You may join everybody else in the living room. Thank you so very, very much. Okay. You don't see it at their age, do you? No. When you're as old as me, you do. Okay, so challenge three. Challenge three is discover open data challenge. Okay, there we go.
The team of Alessio and Antonio. Alessio Salzano and Antonio Galetta.
Alessio and Antonio. Welcome. Big smiles. Yeah, just come on, come on, come on. You can clap, for goodness sake. That's for you. Now you need to give a cheesy grin to the lady in the white trainers there, please. That's critical. The one with the biggest lens, not the one with the, well, yeah, and the one with the smartphone, because she has been incredibly industrious. Fair dude. Yes? Are we good? Who would like to say a couple of words? Thank you. And what it's about, what in a nutshell, what is this?
Thank you very much. To begin with, this is an open data platform that helps people find, understand, and use data. We started with Austrian data, but we look forward for the whole European data to integrate into our platform. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Do you want to add anything?
No, I want only to sleep.
Oh, you want only to sleep. All right. Thank you very much, gents. In fact, we are at the end of this prize, so I can ask the others to come back for a photo, FIWARE to come back for a photo. Oh, now I feel so bad. Oh, I feel so bad. Oh, God. At the end. Oh, no. Okay, at the end. Can you come back, please? Thank you very much, because we're going to do one of those lovely family photos. So that means, can they go behind? Because it's much nicer. Go behind. With a thank you. Just, oh, God, don't take that one away. Oh, okay. Voila, little bit of shenanigans. If you can all, that's okay. You may have a moment. We don't need to rush. We're doing well. Anyone who feels like celebrating excellence may clap now. Thank you. Okay, so ladies and gents, you can stay on the stage. It's not ready. We've just got a little bit of a last award. If you want to go back, just gently make your way back. If the commissioner and the minister can stay with me, we've just got one more. That's it, and then I'm going to ask each of you to give some closing words. Yes. Who's that? I'm so sorry. Wait a second. Let's just do this totally transparently. Give me a second. I'm not clear what you're asking me. I'm so sorry.
No, I just only wanted.
Oh yes, say. Please do say.
So we had many winners here, female and male winners.
Yes.
And we were thinking it would also be great if you asked the female their opinions or things about the prize.
Oh, okay. So are there specific people? No, sorry. No. I'm just, my brain is not there, is it? Sorry. Of those who are here?
Yes, of those who are here. And we noticed that you only asked the male.
Did I? Oh, I thought I left it open for people to... I beg your pardon, that was not my intention. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so, well, I did actually ask one female and she said no, she didn't want to talk. So, and then I picked the person closest to me. But you're absolutely right, and thank you. So, even if you don't want to speak, you are now obliged to speak. Hey-ho, fiddle-dee-dee. Can the cameraman even get these lovely people back here? You are leaping around like a gazelle, sir. You must have burned about 6 billion calories in this event. Please, indeed, if you want to have your moment, I would love to hear from you. Genuinely, go for it.
We want to thank you for this opportunity.
Just hold the mic there.
And also great. Thank our organization, KIOS Center of Excellence, and the University of Cyprus for this.
Please, absolutely. Take your time.
Thank you very much.
Hold it right up there because we won't hear you, lovely. Really, you have to eat it. Sorry. Yeah.
Thank you for this opportunity. It was a great experience.
Okay. Thank you. Who have I missed? Nobody. You don't want me to ask you, do you? You want to be asked? Voila. There you go.
Thank you very much for this... all this recognition about our work in FIWARE, and for to FIWARE to create all these opportunities to validate the use case in industry 4.3.
Yeah, thank you very much for that. You should have said that the first time, because that was very correct what you said. Thank you very much. Thank you to all. And I love that. It's truly interactive, this event, as you can see, physically interactive. So thank you. I'm glad I gave you the opportunity to come and say that. Anyone else who wants to give me any notes, advice, include something, talk to their grandmother, any of that, you can come up. We have a little bit of time left. Right. So we've got one more, and it's this one. So hang on just a little second, please. We're coming to the Imagine, I think we need to do a bumper. We've got the Imagine 18 Idea Marathon Prize. I think we're going to see that on the screen now, please. Before you reveal the winner, I think this took place on December the 5th from 4:30 to 6. Okay, and because ICT technologies are changing all aspects of life and this rapid change poses vital questions, you know all this, what's our vision for the future, digitized future, what the role of humans be in it, how do we expect them to support us, what are the kinds of barriers? So this actual session, this marathon, gave room to participants of all ages, all backgrounds, all generations, all sorts, I love this, including students, critically also students, to share their ideas. And then experts and students gave feedback on the presented ideas, which were evaluated according to originality, how fit for purpose, quality of the presentation. So that gives you a little bit of the background, and now I leave to you, please, to announce the winner.
And the winner is the outreach team Tuvian. The future is now, collaborative, diverse, and technologically literate.
Thank you. The outreach team, could you please come forward? Where are you? Give that to the commissioner, thank you. Hang on. Voila. Just slip down there, move down there, move down there. So, one of you, perhaps take that, and then maybe give this. I love this. It's like a symphony of dance. There we go, for some photos. Voila. Some happiness. And you can all guess who I'm going to ask to say a few words now, can't you? Yeah. Okay, so it's you. I would like to hear from you.
Not a problem for me. I would talk also if there wasn't a...
Okay, hold the mic right up here.
Okay, sorry. What should I say? Okay, we are the outreach team, and our aim is to show people, young students, as well children from kindergarten till the university, what technology means, and that they get this technological literacy. That's the aim of our workshops. And do you want to say also something? Yeah? Okay. And maybe one last word. Future is now. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, ladies and gents, are you happy to go behind? We do this last photo with the last challenge? And then yeah? Do you need them to go behind the hashtag or they can stay here? Oh, you took it. We did it. Oh, fab. Oh, that's marvelous. Do I need to orchestrate any more photos with everybody? Can I release people now? Fantastic. So could you give a last round of applause to all of this brilliance? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so very much. We are going to segue into the very close of the close of the close. Maybe you have a little bit of music, but you may all kindly take your seats and chill as we have a last couple of closing remarks. So, ladies and gentlemen, please do take your seats. Thank you very much. You may go. Now, where are we at? I think as we segue into this close, up to you where you would like to go. You may go off stage or you may stay in as I ask the minister. Off stage? Yeah? Okay, so you may take a seat back there. Thank you very, very much, Commissioner. You may all go there. And we are going to go shortly into our close. And I think we even have a bumper for that. So hang on a moment. Do we have a bumper?
Imagine Digital. Connect Europe.
Okay, hang on a bit. Yes, I probably wasn't very clear. Okay, so I'm going to just put this because I don't want to lose that. And I certainly don't want to speak for you. Yeah, you don't. Okay, he just said if you want to leave your notes there, he can speak for you, but I don't think. And then you can do his. No. So, the podium is yours, or are you going to speak with a mic, or you prefer? Okay, so thank you very much. Please give a very warm round of applause. We're going to hear some closing remarks because it's also very much the twilight of the Austrian presidency as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much. What a day, dear Commissioner, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you. First of all, let me thank the European Commission for organizing this enormous event. The Imagine Digital Connect Europe Conference is the largest expert meeting of the Austrian presidency. This year, we celebrate the 20th anniversary of this European ICT event. And the very first one took place here in Vienna exact 20 years ago. So we both were about 10 or 12 years old, you know, something like that. After 3 days of conference, sessions, exhibitions, and networking, I dare to say, this has been an excellent event. Digitalization is among the top priorities of the Austrian government. My ministry is putting special emphasis on ICT. Since 2012, we have funded approximately 160 cooperative projects at national level, with a total of 200 million euros in subsidies in our national ICT of the Future program. Austria has also promoted artificial intelligence to be a priority topic of our presidency. My ministry has installed a special council on robotics and artificial intelligence. Last week, Austria has presented its national strategy of shaping the future of artificial intelligence in Austria. Moreover, the European Commission, together with the member states, has been working on the development of AI in Europe. Our presidency events have contributed to these ongoing efforts. We initiated a discussion on responsible artificial intelligence of the future. And this was at the European Big Data Value Forum in November, which we continued within the IMAGINE18 program, complementing the discussions on artificial intelligence in the main ICT 2018 conference program. As strong Europe in research, education, technology, and innovation is on one of the goals of our presidency, and AI is one of the areas where cooperation of national and European research is essential. Austria has really a leading position in establishing platforms for the legal and transparent exchange of data. Our Lighthouse project, Data Market Austria, has successfully created an ecosystem for data services. The challenge was to establish rules and procedures for the reuse of data and services. The challenge was also to bring stakeholders together, some of them, of course, competitors. And we want to go one step further. Together with partnering ministries, we recently presented a data intelligence offensive, a comprehensive cooperation of research, industry, and public administration for supporting the transition into the data economy. Austria has always been a strong partner in European research and development programs. We are among, as a small country, you know, we are among the top three most successful member states within Horizon 2020. We have a very high success rate in the program, and also Austrian industries participate very actively. Moreover, in areas such as microelectronics, Austria is now a major player. As you have surely found out, we integrated our national conference, Imagine, into the ICT 2018 event this year. Our intention in designing the Imagine 18 was to help you imagine digital technologies of the future by engaging different perspectives on this topic. The motto of this year's Imagine 18 program was technology bridging generations. We invited teenagers from international schools. We invited Austrian national ICT stakeholders from research and industry, and we invited you, European ICT stakeholders, to imagine the future of ICT with us. And we got some excellent results. We just saw the winner of the Idea Marathon. They're a little bit tired, I think. This was a great opportunity to network Austrian and European research and development and work on innovation of the future together. Almost 1,000 of the over 6,000 ICT participants are from Austria. The other 5,000 are from about 100 countries all around the world. I hope you had time to visit the Austrian village. Some of you might even have found new cooperation partners here. Maybe this cooperation will bring you back to Austria one day. You are more than welcome. I sincerely hope you had a really great time in Vienna. Have a safe trip home, and thank you for coming. Thank you so much.
Thank you very, very much. And I tell you, one of the joys of moderating in different topics in different countries is that you will always get at ministerial or other level, you will always say where you feel very proud and strong. That was very, very interesting, your statistic about Horizon 2020. Small country, one of the top three. So thank you. Well-deserved pride. I did tweet yesterday. I said, big up to the European Commission and the Austrian presidency for this event. Really, I commend you and salute you. Thank you very much. A very warm round of applause for this lovely gentleman. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, for some closing remarks, could you please give a very warm welcome back to Commissioner Mariya Gabriel? Thank you very much. Now you may come here. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Dear Minister Hofer, dear Members of Parliament, ladies and gentlemen, after three intense but eye-opening and inspirational days, ICT 2018, Europe's largest event for the digital research and innovation community, is coming to a close. But ICT 2018, Minister, attracted over 6,000 participants from more than 100 countries. That was a truly global event. More than 120 networking sessions, provided opportunities for new partnerships. ICT 2018, the exhibition, was a unique opportunity to discover groundbreaking, innovative results from over 100 European-funded projects. But the numbers tell only part of the story. ICT 2018 has above all been a showcase of the digital excellence to be found in every corner of Europe. Here in Vienna, business and policy leaders have shared their vision and learned about the advances of Europe's research community. Ambitious researchers and innovators were able to present their current results and future ambitions for the digital society. It was very appropriate to end the ICT 2018 by celebrating such excellence, hence announcing the winners of the FIWARE and Innovation Radar Prizes. I applaud again the winners for their work so far and wish them all success for their next steps. Last month, the Financial Times interestingly suggested that Europe needs to shout louder about its strengths in digital research. A couple of minutes ago, we also numerous examples of this European strength received a prize here at stage. They deserve a spotlight on them and their achievements. So let's continue to raise our voice and shout about these and other successes. We have an abundance of digital excellence in Europe. It's time we stop being shy about it. And when it comes to supporting your excellent work, you can trust the European Commission to spare no efforts. We already talk about our European strategy for digital technologies. We already talk about Horizon Europe and Digital Europe program. So please, act as ambassadors in your own member states and your communities. With your work, you can show very concretely why these investments will make a difference for our common future. So thank you to all for being here and making this event so big success. Special thanks naturally go to Minister Hofer and his colleagues of the Austrian presidency of the European Union for their ongoing support in advancing digital policies and program, for their engagement, commitment and energy. Last but not least, thank you very much to my colleagues from DG Connect of the European Commission. They have worked tirelessly for many months to make this event possible, and their great enthusiasm means a lot to me. Let me applaud you all for your conviction and ambition. That's the true asset to seize the digital opportunities as from today and in the years to come. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So, we are there. Woo, we're actually 2 minutes. I'm not going to be longer than 2 minutes. We're going to finish at 2 o'clock. Thank you very much. Can I please echo the sentiments and the request of the Commissioner to get stories out there? I can tell you that even conversations with taxi drivers and others on Brexit when I've been back to London where I come from, I have managed to shift the way people think. Stories, stories, stories. They're critical. Just the last few words from me as the main moderator of this absolutely epic event. I think the most epic I have ever done on a brain-challenging point of view and a physical point of view. So can I just say, of course, a big thank you to the European Commission, DG Connect. I would like to echo the Commissioner's words. I know because the people who have helped to brief me, talk to me, gather all the information for the different sessions have been tremendous. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You've been incredibly focused. Thank you, as I said again, to the Austrian presidency for organizing and hosting this conference. I have about
75 minutes to go and see something of Vienna, which is tragic, but I will see it, okay? So thank you very much. Huge thanks to our wonderful speakers. I mean, so many of them who've taken the time and trouble to be here and download the contents of their considerable brains, and the ones who are with me simply cracking the whip. Thank you to the interpreters today. We have two there. Oh, I love that. They're saluting. Oh, and waving. Thank you very, very much. Typically, before I thank all of you, I have to say a massively big up to the technicians. I mean, God, it was huge. There are people there, there are people there, there are people in every room, there are people downstairs. It has been a mega event. Can you please, with the energy that you have left, there is a phenomenal team back here. They have been working day and night and back there. A huge, huge round of applause. And that includes our tremendous cameramen. I mean, you've seen this guy, as I said, honestly, he can eat as much blooming strudel as he wants now. He's not going to put on a single bloody kilo. So absolutely tremendous. And a big thank you to you. Those of you who are still with us online, those of you here, obviously without you, without your input, without your drive, your questions, your buzz, the event absolutely would have been completely pointless. So take it forward, be the best multipliers that you can be. And I think I will just echo the two Fs, the FT that the commissioner just said, and that lovely Finn on our last HPC panel, let's be proud. It's important. It's really important to be proud of Europe, and I won't have a word said against it. So I wish you very much luck and fortitude and all the rest going home in your ongoing endeavors. Of course, have a very safe trip home, and actually sod the gin and tonic. I'm going to go and eat strudel. Really, I haven't eaten it yet. Thank you very, very much. It was very good to be with you. Thank you. Thank you.